Sam and Mixed Up Craft. Thanks for watching my tutorial today. I've got this really fun, never-ending greeting card. Now, the idea of this came when I watched a YouTube video by Trimcraft, which are a British crafting company, and they put up a quick kind of high-speed video. So there was no instructions as such. It was just watching them quickly put this never-ending card together. And I thought it was brilliant. So I played around with the measurements, and this is my own measurements and design, but the concept has obviously been done before. And if you put in never-ending cards, you'll see loads. But the one that I got the inspiration from today was from Trimcraft. And basically what it is, this is the front, and then you open it up and you get this, and then you open it up and you get this, and it literally just never ends. You just keep going around and around. So back to the beginning again, so on, so on. That one I love. And this is the piece that I've used as the end of it, because as soon as you fold that over, you then come back to the beginning again. And I thought that this piece here was nice to have the sentiments you could put your to and from. And then I've just really kind of used papers, stamps, different die cuts, all sorts of things. I have kept the colours all the same, so all the papers I've used were from an old Stamping Up paper pack, and that's what I used throughout. And then the flowers have come from a where did I just put that? Let me just see where I put it. Ah, here. Oh, it's from this here, which is an unbranded die that I got on eBay. Was it eBay? I can't remember now. Anyway, I'll put the link. I'll find the link. But it's brilliant because you just run it through and it cuts out loads. So that's what I use for these. And then inside here, I've just done some heat embossing. I've got a nice little sentiment there. Growing old is mandatory. Growing up is optional. I thought that was quite nice. And then this one here, the only, this is where I guess I've gone wrong. I haven't gone wrong, but what you would do is obviously whatever you're sticking here, you have to be aware that you're going to see, it has to match every time you fold, whatever your design is. And I guess on this one here, this is a nice page, but it has got this here. But I wanted these big sentiments. So I like it, but that is something that people will pick up, because then when you fold it back again, you've got this lovely story. So it is quite hard to be able to have nice stories on every page. But if you want to put a sentiment or something, you have to keep it within this thin rectangle. Because if I go back to that one again, really, if you want, you would have your sentiment here coming down that way or along that way. I guess it doesn't matter. Or you would have it along this piece here. So that would be the only piece that I guess, if you're being really picky and you don't like that, then that is what I would say you need to do differently there. But I am going to show you how to make it. I'm going to make a 6x6 one. So this is an 8x8. I will put all the measurements for the 8x8 in my blog, which will be in the video description below. But in terms of quantities of what you'll need of these shapes, it's the same as what I will be doing for the 6x6 now. So just write all the quantities down. And then if you want the measurements, like I said, everything will be for the 8x8, will be on my blog. But just one more time there. Really, really pretty. That one there. These also I've got, which I'll show you because I'll be using them on the next project. That's my favourite one. And then back to the beginning. And also it stands up. So that's another nice added feature. So it still will look nice on top of someone's mantle on their you know, side table and things like that. Okay, so pop that one to one side, and you are going to need lots and lots of pieces. So like I said, check out my blog or grab a pen and paper. So first of all, you will need two pieces of 6x6, and then I've just cut down the middle there, so they're 3x6. Then you will need, start from these little bits here, you need four pieces of, I think it was 1¼, yeah, 1¼ square of pattern paper. So again, this is another old Stamping Up paper pack, so they all go together. Then you need 10 pieces, I believe, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and yeah, 10 pieces of 1¼ by 2¾. Okay, and then you need 8 pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pieces of 2 and 3 quarter square. Okay. So again, all of those measurements will be in the video description below in my blog. And then you just need loads and loads of flowers and sentiments cut. I mean, they'll be the thing that you'll do last. That's everything you're going to need. And then just start putting it together. So what you want to do is grab your scoreboard. Okay, so with your scoreboard, first of all, you want to score them all the same. So along the 6-inch side here, you're going to score at 1.5 and then at 4.5. Okay, so do that on all four pieces. So 1.5 and 4.5. And then grab your bone tool and you just want to fold in each of those sides. Oh, did I just knock my camera? Sorry, I thought I knocked my camera there. Just fold each one in. I need to trim some of my little fluffy edges on this paper because it's I think my blade's gone again. I go through loads of blades on my cutter. And what you want to make sure here is make sure that they don't overflap. They should just meet each other. Okay. Because it's... I'll go through that bit in a minute. But okay, so you have all your four pieces. And just open two of them out and put them upside down, like so. And then these two open up, again upside down, and have them. So you've got two this way and two that way. And then what you want to do, keep those two to one side, is just grab some tape and you're going to pop tape. The tape I use is, did I say this was last time? Yeah, 1/2 inch. So you want to put tape 1 inch down within that, those two end, kind of like 1.5 inch little tabs that we created. Okay, so I know that that's 1 inch down. And that's what you want to do for that one. And then on this one, turn it upside down. You want to do it on the bottom. So again, I can just...
Okay, so I've just taken the backing off of those.
Grab the top one here. Bring these two pieces over. You want to keep them perfectly lined up. Well, first of all, don't worry too much about that for the minute. You want to get this one here. Okay, so these two are facing down. This one's facing the other way. And you want to make sure that you line it up nicely to the corner there, so it's completely flush, like so.
Turn it around this way,
and then, just because I don't want to lean in front of the camera, I'm just going to turn it upside down so it's closer to me. There we go. Just need to trim that piece off there where I just ripped it. There we go. Okay, so that's the top one, so it's stuck across. And then with the bottom, so again with the same piece, you then want to line up the bottom one there. And when you do this, make sure that when it meets here, again it lies completely flat and flush against that one. And again, just allow that one to fall into place, like so. And that is the card. So I'll talk you through. So there's the front here, these two panels, then you fold it over. Now when you fold it over, grab your bone tool, just burnish all of those, and then fold this one here, and again grab your bone tool and then you're back to that one again. And then just keep doing it, and basically just make sure that all of this is nice and smooth and it's not catching. So see, it's hard to show you there, but when this one opens, you want to make sure that these kind of flaps here aren't catching underneath that, and so on. If it is at all, see, it's a little bit there. Can you kind of see? Kind of, I could probably just shave a little bit off with my snips. So if you've got anything catching like that, just grab a pair of your snips and just go along very finely. Just take off a little hair, kind of hairline of it, just so that you get a smoother finish. But basically, that is the mechanism. So it's really, 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 really easy. So now it's just down to decorating. So that's my front. So with all of those larger squares, everywhere where you have a square, I'm going to stick them down. So I've got two here, I've then got two here,
And then this is the back of the beginning ones, so two here, and then you're back to the beginning again. So I'm going to go ahead and stick these down. I've got all different patterns, so bear that in mind when you go to cut all your pieces. And maybe I know what I'm doing here because I've obviously already made one, but what you might want to do is cut them out, kind of roughly put them in place, don't stick them, and then see what it's like when you open each side and check that you're happy with it. So I'm going to go ahead and stick all of those pieces down. Okay, so that's all of my square pieces stuck down. And once you put this all into place, it becomes a lot stronger as well. So I can see there how it's all going to start coming together. So that one there, and so on. So now I'm going to stick down all of my
there's those side pieces.
Now, so they're all into place. You can see again as you start moving it how it's all going to look. Actually, it's only that one page at the minute with those ones. So now I'm going to go and stick all of these down into place. Okay, so that's all the squares in place. So now as I do this, you can see how that's a really nice one. And then that one there. And then back out. And so on. And that's it. That's the guard. It's just, like I said, it's so easy. You know, anybody can do this. You don't need a scoreboard. You can do this with just a ruler and just cut everything down. And you know, you need very little bits and pieces. And if you don't have die cutting and things like that, you can just use stickers and things like that will look equally nice. So I'm now going to go ahead and just decorate mine just to give you some inspiration. But in terms of the card itself, it's done. So if you want to end the video now, you can. I won't be offended. But if you do want to hang around and watch a bit more, then do. This is my start. So it's kind of the same as this. Well, it is the same as that one for the minute. And then it goes that way. And this one, obviously, it is the same, sorry. So that one faces that way. You can turn this one. I can have the sentiment that way or that way. It doesn't matter. And then folds that way, which is this one here. So you can see where I've got that overlaying and I've got the flower overlaying there. That's fine. I like that. And like I said, this doesn't bother me. So it's entirely up to you. And I'm going to have a couple of sentiments there. And then again, that's that one, which then becomes this one, which is my favourite one. So again, I'm going to have a nice sentiment there. I might decide to put a couple of bits here as well if I want to. And then you're back to the beginning. Like so. So there you have it. I hope you like it. I hope I explained it well enough. I'm just going to trim some of the fluffy edges off of mine there. I will also add the size envelope for this one on the envelope punch board for everybody that has that. But yeah, there you go. Nice and easy. So hit the thumbs up if you like this one and subscribe to my channel to see more. Thanks for watching. Bye.